This is a celiac artery angiogram. You can see here the catheter that has been passed from the femoral artery into the abdominal aorta. It reaches the abdominal aorta from the femoral via the external iliac, then common iliac. This is the site of the catheter. And radio-opaque material is injected into the celiac trunk. You can see some of the branches of the celiac trunk. This is the splenic artery. It's a big branch and characterized by its tortuosity. It's very clear, the tortuosity of the artery. The other branch is the common hepatic artery. This is the common hepatic artery. And here it continues as the proper hepatic. The proper hepatic artery divides into a left hepatic and a right hepatic branch. And you can see here that the right hepatic artery provides a small branch, that is the cystic artery, that supplies the gallbladder. So this is the cystic artery. The common hepatic artery provides a gastroduodenal artery here. This is the gastroduodenal artery that passes behind the first part of the duodenum. And the gastroduodenal artery provides a right gastroepiploic artery. You can see this is the right gastroepiploic artery that courses in the greater omentum along the greater curvature of the stomach. In addition to that, the gastroduodenal artery provides superior pancreaticoduodenal artery. This is the superior pancreaticoduodenal artery. It divides into an anterior and posterior branches that straddle the head of the pancreas, and they supply the duodenum and the pancreas. They anastomose with the inferior pancreaticoduodenal artery that comes from the superior mesenteric artery. Thank you.